What's up, guys? Today we're going to have a quick look at the XPR Network Block Explorer and see some of the awesome features and functions, how to use it, and basically just a quick overview. So the first thing we're going to notice when we land on the XPR Network Block Explorer is the homepage here. You can see we've got the price of XPR, we've got some interesting information up the top here, the current max transactions that we've seen today, which is 594 per second. The amount of accounts, how many new accounts have signed up in the last 24 hours, and some useful links. You can also see here the list of block producers that are currently producing and their rank. Now, block producers are the ones that keep the network, they're the ones behind the network infrastructure. They're keeping all the servers maintained, basically making sure the network is online. And these block producers are rewarded for that. And you can see the rewards per day, how many total votes they've got, the vote percentage, and some other information. Now, when you actually go and stake XPR in the WebAuth wallet, you're going to be asked to vote for four block producers. Here is where you come and learn a little bit more about each block producer. So you can click the web link or the X or Twitter link and find out, you know, what they've been posting about online, what they're up to, how they're contributing to the XPR network community, and various other things. Once you've gone through the list, you can then make your decision, I guess. But currently there's 32 block producers, all vying for the top spot, obviously. So if you are staking on XPR Network, do shift your votes around, support some of the small block producers, and keep decentralization alive. So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna step through some of the options here. I'm gonna start off with the login feature, and I'll show you what that looks like if we start from the beginning. So we're going to click login, and of course, right now I'm using the webauth.com wallet. I'm going to click that and go browser. I am already logged in under my pool account, so that should be nice and easy. Basically authorize, and boom, you can see up here, pool, logged in. Now I can go ahead and click view account, and here's where I can see some information about my account, the liquid XPR, how much is short staked, long staked if you've got any long staked, and you can see here the transaction history. So everything that's happened on chain under my account is here, and you can go through the various pages. So depending on the account you logged in with, when you click this little drop down here, if you're logged in with pool, you should see pool here at the bottom, and you can click that. You can also search for other accounts if you'd like. Of course, it is blockchain and everything is transparent on chain. It is an open ledger. So there it is. Now I'm going to go back to the home page. I'm going to click wallet. So now we know how to search the different accounts here, and you can plug your transaction ID in, account name, etc., etc. But we're going to click here on the wallet feature, and we're going to work our way through this left-hand side. So first of all, we've got a very simple feature, which is transfer tokens. So I want to do an example transfer, pool 123. I'm going to set 1,000 XPR test tutorial. And of course, when I click transfer, it's going to open up my WebAuth wallet that I connected with earlier. Go ahead and use my YubiKey to verify or sign that transaction. And boom, just like that. So you can see here, I've got a transaction ID. So if I click that, you can actually see a little bit more information about the transaction. So you can see here, pool sent 1000 XPR to pool 123. Over here, you can see the contract it's actually using. EOSIO.token is the core token contract for XPR, and you can see here the action that it took. So it was a very clearly a transfer action on the EOSIO.token smart contract. Now, if I was to actually click on this EOSIO.token smart contract, you can see here, just like any account, you can go through the transaction history. But the unique and awesome thing about XPR Network is you can actually click on contract and see some of the actions that are associated with that smart contract. So remember, every account is essentially a smart contract, but different smart contracts have different actions and obviously code and options and have different things that you can do. Here on the EOSIO.token smart contract, it's kind of like a system smart contract, like a default one. We've got the transfer action, we've got obviously a bunch of other actions here, but in this case, I'm just going to click transfer just to show you an example of how this works. So I want to send some XPR from pool to pool 123. You can see here, if I go put what I'd like in, test. Now this is telling the blockchain that I want to do the transfer action on this particular smart contract. which handles the transfers for the XPR token itself. So I've done that, and boom, a successful transaction. Of course, I can click that transaction ID, click on pool, and you can see the two transactions that we just made here. Both work fine, both work great. You can see there's a little bit of time until finality, but everything's instant and happens on chain. Of course, you can see the various token information here. If you're on any account, you can see the tokens they've got in their account. You can see the keys that are associated with that account. These are the public keys. Never put your private key online. For every account, there's always a public key and a private key. So you need your private key, obviously, to do any actions on chain, such as transfer, staking, or anything like that. Public key is essentially just your address, right? So over here, I'm going to go back to wallet, and we're going to have, last time we looked at transfer, basic transfer. Now you can do multi-transfer, which means you can transfer multiple currencies at once, multiple tokens. You just toggle them on, which ones you want, the amount you want to send. Batch transfer basically allows you to upload a CSV of a list of accounts and which tokens and how much of that token you want to send, and it will all just sort of happen at once for you. Nice and easy if you've got, say, like 100 people you want to, you know, send some XPR to, for example. You can use this to get it all done in one upload. You can, of course, transfer NFTs, transfer batch NFTs, and basically, just like a token, you can transfer those to an account that you'd like. Next on the left over here, we've got short stake. Like I mentioned earlier, whenever you do stake, you will need to vote for four block producers. If you've already put your votes in for block producers, you may not be asked to do it here on the Explorer, but if you'd like to update your votes, you can go over to vote here and select the block producers you'd like to vote for. Simply check the four on here on the checkboxes and then click vote, authorize your transaction, and your block producers will be selected. Now remember, there are no, it doesn't matter who you vote for as a block producer, you have to pick four. You can pick any four, or you can go through the list I showed you earlier here on the homepage and go through and decide which ones you'd like to vote for. But basically, it doesn't matter who you vote for. At the end of the day, if you vote for, your rewards are going to stay the same no matter who you vote for. So it's up to you who you'd like to support. So if we go over to short stake again, I can show you a quick example of us doing some staking. So maybe I want to stake, say, 10,000 XPR. Go ahead and click stake, and we'll get the authorization, which I will do. Hit the security key, and voila, we've just staked some more XPR. You can see that's instantly changed our short staked amount here. Shows us how much liquid XPR we've got left. Down here you can see the variable APR, which is close to 5%, 4.82% right now. You can see how much I've staked in total, and how much is staked on the network in total, which is really interesting. You can, of course, unstake if you'd like. You can claim rewards, and if you've unstaked and you haven't seen that XPR back in your account, you may need to click this refund button here, but that's very, very rare. Long staking, I'm not going to go into that today, but it's another form of staking which kind of compares the price of XPR and Bitcoin. If the price of Bitcoin, you know, moves up, goes up faster than the price of XPR, based on the time when you did the long staking, you might get some additional XPR minted to bring your XPR value up to the same value as Bitcoin. It's kind of like an insurance policy. Really interesting, but we'll look into that another day. Tax export. This is really handy if you're doing your taxes or your accountant is. You can download a CSV with all of the transactions or the last 10,000 transactions from your account. Simply type your name in, click download CSV, and you'll get the CSV, which you can then take to cointracking.info and import all those transactions. And yeah, you can see some, there are some notes down here which you need to be aware of. Get your accountant or whoever to read these, and just ensure that you've got a full understanding of all the transactions. Here you can create an account, and you can create a sub-account essentially, which normally when you create an account through the Webauth wallet, you get enough resources as like a basic account to do basic things free. Here, if you're creating a sub-account based on another account, you'll have to buy the RAM. It's very cheap. You buy approximately 3,000 bytes as the default. But basically what this means is you can put in the owner key for another account. here's one I prepared earlier. So if I go to my pool wallet and then go over here to children, you can see some of the accounts that I've created using the same public key as my pool account. This basically allows me to control these child accounts with my main pool account. Keys and permissions. This is a really unique feature of XPR Network. On like Ethereum, if you lose your private key, you're kind of screwed. You've got to throw that account out, right? Here on the XPR Network, say your private key gets leaked or whatever, you can actually update your key here. So you can go over here to utilities, generate some new keys. Remember, you need to save these somewhere very safe. Do not put them, do not screenshot them, do not put them in your notes folder or anything like that. When you are generating a key pair, make sure you grab the key pair. And then if you want to update your keys on your account, you just need to copy this public key, ensure you've got the private key saved, go over to keys and permissions, and you can actually paste in here a new public key, and that will wipe all of your other pass keys, for example. In here, if I refresh this and have a look at my active account. So every account has an owner, which is kind of like the admin, and active, which is kind of like the user. Owner can overwrite everything the active account does. So generally, the owner account, you might want to make that it's unique, its own sort of key pair, its own private key. Hide that away in a safe somewhere, super or a lockbox or whatever, and ensure that's fully secure and hidden. Over here is the active key. Now, active, you can basically do anything on your account, whether it's transfer, trade, use the swap protocol, lending protocol. And you can see here I've got all my public keys. So each public key is assigned to a different passkey device. So you can see public WA for WebAuth. And if you do overwrite your active key, for example, it's going to wipe all of those active passkey devices. And then the only way you'll be able to sign a transaction is with the private key, the associated private key for this. Now, you can import that private key into your WebAuth wallet or into another wallet and interact with the blockchain with your new key. There's also this advanced tab, which basically allows you to do more advanced things with the permissions. I'm not going to go into that today. You need to be very careful in here. Ensure that you've done your research and maybe do some tests on another account. You can actually set create an msig in here. You can set certain permissions. So maybe you want a certain key to only interact with certain smart contracts or use certain actions on those smart contracts. You can do that in here. Just like an operating system, you can restrict privileges and permissions of certain users and accounts that you own, of course. Finally, if we go over to utilities, I showed you this just a second ago, the ability to generate keys. You can format your keys here if you've got your seed phrase and you want to convert that seed phrase into a private key, you can do that here. But yeah, I think that's pretty much more or less it. If we go over to chain, you can get a little bit more information about the blockchain itself, how much chain RAM is available, how much has been bought. If you go over to tokens up here, you can see the different tokens that have been minted on XPR Network, the various X tokens here, their market cap, the volume, issued supply. Oracles are, of course, price updates that are written to the blockchain, basically decentralized price indexes. These are written to the blockchain. Every blockchain and everyone in DeFi kind of has these oracles. Great thing about oracles on XPR Network is obviously they're very cheap to maintain and run because there are no gas fees, right? On most blockchains, there are gas fees you have to deal with. Writing and reading all this data can take time and money. So we're lucky with the XPR Network with our superior technology. Of course, if you go over here to supply, you're going to find some information about the token, XPR, how much is issued, staked, wrapped, circulating, and all those things. And we've got that information here for both XPR and loan. Finally, if you click the swap button over here on the right, it is going to take you to the Metal X app, the DeFi Super app, and you can do all your swaps, trades, farming, bridging, and everything over here. So I hope that was kind of useful and helpful for those that have never used the Explorer before. That's about it for today. Thank you so much for your time and checking out the XPR Network. If you've got any more questions or suggestions for videos, please let me know in the comments. Please like this video, share it, follow me, and all that good stuff. Peace.